Well, I'm here to introduce my friend and colleague from IITD, Mr. Vimal Panchal. He's an ambitious business professional with strong and studied 2 decades of experience with professional brilliance, predominantly in the area of sales and business development for more than 15 years now. And since last 5 years, he's actively involved in strategic management, managing multi-level business, global, large accounts, government, channel sales, part of product and program management team. His key skills are management, sales, business development, process improvement, and P&L management. Well, friends, there's a lot to know more about Vimal. Of course, he's one of the speakers or a friend whom I have known since we started IITD sessions. He's very sweet, has a very calm personality, very friendly, easily connects with people, doesn't have that dualness inside him, and that is what people attract towards him. So we all of us welcome you, Mr. Vimal, and we are sure we'll be having a beautiful journey, 40-minute journey with you, and have beautiful takeaways for the day. So all of us, please give a round of applause and welcome Vimal Panchal.
Yeah,
thank you.
Wonderful,
so much.
Wonderful.
Over Deepika. To you, Vimal. Thank you.
Thank you
all the best.
So much. It was so delightful to hear from the Deepika, and I'm so overwhelmed to have this kind of introduction about me, first time ever. Thank you so much, Deepika. And it's given me a responsibility with the sense that I have to live up to that expectations that I'm going to cover this topic today, which I have decided for my 40-minute presentation. So thank you, Deepika. With that notes, I'm starting my presentations. And good morning to all of you.
Good morning.
As I can see, my backgrounds, it's coming from the human's mind. And before I jump into a topic, I wanted to connect and address the topic where it comes from. So people in general, we all think on a daily basis, some or other way, the thinking process always goes, keep in always there is in mind. What kind of thinking we do, what is more required for our thinking proper activities, and how is going to help us in our coming ways. So before I go and present, I wanted to ask you one simple question, if anyone can answer. Generally, what kind of thinking we do? Anyone? It's an open question to everyone.
Yeah, Vimal, Sanjay here. The thinking has been generally absolutely random. Like we more or less react and respond to the way the situation comes, and the thinking enhances accordingly. So not much of the specific thinking. If I talk about general, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. You bang on the point, Sanjay bhai. So thinking, it's always there in our back of mind. Anybody else who would like to know more elaborate about what is thinking process we are going to do?
Yeah, may I please?
Yeah, please.
Yeah. So we also always think about the future and what's going to happen, yeah. And how things are going to pan out.
Yeah, correct. Well, absolutely correct, Adambariji. Yeah. One more hand I can see.
We think that there is a whether this thing will happen or not.
Okay. I can't see that person, but
Kalpana.
Kalpana.
Yeah, okay, Kalpana.
So there is always a doubt like whether this will happen or not.
I can see hands raised by Mr. Vivek. Yeah. If Mr. Vivek can, yeah.
Because thinking depends upon the environment or the circumstances in which we are.
Yeah.
So that depends on that, and it influences us to think.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. So it depends on the environment, it depends what situation we are in, or maybe the future thinking is most prevalent in today's time, that we always think about the future, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Right. So friends, absolutely right on the points that what kind of thinking are we doing on a daily basis, on the regular basis. Let me share my screen. If you can all able to see, just let me know. And from where I can...
Yes, we can see.
Yeah, okay. Is it visible to all of you?
Yes.
So formally, let me greet you all of you by joining hands and wish everyone Sukh, Shanti, and Samruddhi to the coming days and life and coming to the new year for all of us. And with that, I start my formal presentations to all of you. As my topic itself says about think to achieve, and when I'm saying think to achieve, many of my friends has given the answer, what is the thinking is all about. Thinking would have been a different ways, different time zone, different situation to in. And that brings me a topic, and that today's topic to talk about more in details, what kind of thinking we all do. This is not a definition, my friends. It is not a definition of thinking. It is just, you know, the understanding what thinking does for all of us. When I am saying thinking, my thinking will be different than your thinking. And someone else thinking will be different from someone else. Because as my friends, as you already just mentioned, thinking depends on the situation we are in, the what kind of thought process we are generally go through it. And that brings in thinking process in all, like in, you know, a regular practice to us. To me, what is thinking? It's absolutely a taking the lots of new ideas while you start thinking to that. Okay. All the endpoints is talk about to take the decisions. Decision based of that, those decisions will help you in the future by storing that in your mind. It retrieves as and when it comes and the requirement of the thinking process. It kind of sense of experience, the organizes the overall information, which helps you to take decisions by giving a proper thinking in life. You keep asking the questions to yourself, why do I do this, right? We do that, right? Every time we ask the questions to ourselves, if I'm going to do something in life, if there's a new action which I'm going to take, it always asks questions to ourselves first. Are we doing right? Are we doing the right way? And that makes a decision. So thinking is nothing but is a process which we all go through it, and time and again, we'll keep involving ourselves in multiple way of thinking. But my friends, it's not the one kind of thinking in the world. If you see all the corporate world, the spiritual world, all you take any examples. When we talk thought about the thinking, the primary three things comes in the mind. The major thinking, there are multi way of the thinking, but if you look at prima facie, the first one is the critical. When I'm saying critical one, it's more about the instructional. It is does not relate to any individual, but it is more about as a group instruction thinking. Then second comes the analytical. Analytical, pure of the logical. It's the binary thinking. It's a result oriented. There is no what you call pros and cons. It's all about logical thinking. And then comes the creative thinking. Okay, so creative thinking, the things which is there in front of you, you don't think the way it is has to be. You always think out of the box. That will involve logical, creative thinking. Always the new ideas. If I have the options to mute everyone, or can Purvisa help me with them, or to mute other people except me? Okay, I keep going on. The fourth way of thinking, which is the mindfulness thinking. Kalpana ma'am, can I request, please go and mute. Yeah. Am I audible?
Yeah, Vimal, very
thank
much.
Thank you. So, the fourth one, which is the mindfulness thinking, that's the topic for me, which I wanted to talk about more in details, right? We all study critical thinking, analytical thinking, creative, and we keep on doing on a regular basis as and when time comes, as Kadambari says, the creative thinking more related to your future. What I'm going to do next. The critical thinking is about the situation. If you are in a situation where all you need the instruction from the thinkers, and analytical, doing the things right, logical. But I am talking about the mindfulness thinking, which is your present. Where are you today? Are you in your present mind? How are you going to take the decision going forward? So guys, I wanted to take you involved in one small activity, which is around just take your three or four minutes. I know this activity has already been done earlier, but to relate to this topic, to relate to your mind, I want all of you to just be on your comfortable positions. If you are sitting, be really comfortable. If you are there on your standing positions, be comfortable. All we need to do is that just keep close your eyes. Gently take the breathing in and out. Don't analyze anything. Just be normal. I'll give you instruction because I am your host. for just time being. But when I do, when I give instructions, start that activity, then only start and just follow the, you know, the step which I'm going to tell you. Now we all, please gently close your eyes. Just start breathing in and out. Don't analyze anything. Be calm, compose. Start to observing from your head first. Come to your left eyes, right eyes. Check your nostrils. Feel your ears, left ears, right ears. Come to your neck. See your, feel your throat position. Gradually come down. Check your left hand, right hand. Gradually come down. Feel your breathing to your chest. Come to your belly. Feel your thighs. Keep your arm on thighs. Check your knees. Gradually go down. Check your foot, your toes and finger. Stop for a while. Open your eyes slowly. Open your eyes slowly. Don't give me any feedback now. Now we'll do this exercise again with the different instruction now. Okay. Keep close your eyes gently again. But now when you do your body scan with your mind, just try to find out, do you have any pain in your body? Do you find any kind of trouble in breathing? Now you start with the analysis. Okay. Do it. Start it again. Feel your forehead. Check your nostril. Come to your throat. Check your both the shoulder, left shoulder, right shoulder. Your breathing, your belly, your thighs, your knees, your foot, your toes, and finger. Continue the eyes closed. Don't open it as of now. Do it once again. Check your body scan with your mind. Now please gently open your eyes. Now I would like to hear your feedback having this exercise, what you feel before by analytical and what you feel after that. Anyone, any two or three, I will have a choice to invite people to just ask for that. May I have the right to ask people? Payal, can I ask people? Can I choose the people?
Yes, of course you can.
So you are the first one, the chosen one.
But I believe Sanjay wanted to say something. So.
Yeah, definitely. I come to Sanjay bhai. I can't ignore Sanjay bhai.
Okay, so the first in the first half, when you did the activity,
yeah,
you went very fast, and you know, instructions were not. I mean, they were clear.
Yes.
I couldn't follow that much. But the second time, when you said, you know, look for a pain somewhere, you know, concentrate more. I thought that was better for me.
Yeah. So I'll take your feedback. I wanted to come on this point again because that was the exercise is all about. Yeah, Sanjay bhai.
Yeah, Vimal, very, very different kind of experience. The first time when I tried with my hands and I was feeling everything through my external sensory perception, not much of the mind activity was involved. My awareness was not to that extent. But when I closed the eyes second time and I had to scan it once again through my mind, so I could see the awareness, internal awareness was much more sharpened, basically. And I could focus more on the every part when I started from top to bottom. So that was a very different kind of experience. I think I feel more awareful after the second time, after the second.
Thank you, Sanjay bhai. It was really good feedback, which is relate and relevant to this topic. Mr. Ganesh, I can't say no to you.
Yeah, thanks, Vimal. So basically, the first time when you ask us to close our eyes and do not think anything, so that instructions were very clear. And then we went scan ourselves as per your instructions. That was fine. So we did not think. But second time when you purposely or could be your plan, where you mentioned that you have to think about your problem. So first of all, I thought of, I need to focus on some problem of my body, and I focus there. And then you, when you ask us to scan from the hair, forehead, eyes, and something, so still sometimes my focus went to the point where I had an issue. So that's what I realized, that even though people are giving instructions, but when somebody asks that you focus on this particular or your challenge, even though somebody is giving some other instruction, our focus remains still there where we are facing some challenge. That's what I personally feel.
Thank you, Ganesh. Anybody from the group? Because I hardly know any of them from the weekdays best, so I just open the floor if anybody would like to share their experience.
Vimal, Rakesh here. Can I?
Yeah, Rakesh ji.
It was an amazing experience. Even the first time, the moment I closed my eyes and started scanning, I started getting relaxed. I could feel my nerves were getting relaxed and muscles were relaxing. And the experience kept on expanding. And you said not to analyze, I started analyzing. I should do it every day, every moment, every few hours, so that I can focus more or I can be more mindful.
Yeah. Thank you. Correct. So my all dear friends, best words is all about the mindfulness. It's nothing related to your external words. Be present right at the moment. If you are right at the moment, if you do with the thoroughly of your mind scan, your mind is involved in every activities, then you realize that what are you going to do. We all travel by airlines. All we travel by airlines, right?
Yeah. Yes, but
the air hostess comes and gives instructions. If there is a turbulence happen, the oxygen mask will fall down, right? So take the oxygen mask first to your mouth and then trying to help to others. So this is nothing but to helping yourself first. Be available for yourself first, then the others. If you are happy by yourself, you always go and spread the happiness to all other people. If you are happy by doing something new, then it brings the awareness, the happiness to the other people. So this is all about be available yourself first, be do yourself first, and then the legacy will definitely transform by the nature of the way to the other people. And that's what we all doing, the mindfulness thinking purposely, right? We do all other thinking definitely, going period of time. But when it comes to the mindfulness thinking, that is all about when I say to you, just do the 5 minutes exercise by keeping your eyes closed. I ask you to paying attention. Okay. When I given the instruction second time, it was more about the purpose, right? The paying attention to yourself first. You close the eyes, you start to scan your body through your mind. Okay. It was not just when I'm given instruction, you do that. When I'm involving you with your mind, you start, you listening to yourself first. You are not here to listening to me, you started to listening to yourself. You are watching your body through your inner eyes, okay? You are trying to be a naturally exist. You feel the inhale, you feel the, if there's any body pain with your body, you start to know, it's time to find it out. And it was all purposefully. Because if there's no purpose, you will not able to do such kind of any activities in your life. I'm saying you, that means it's all about we as in life. Sorry to, and pardon me if I'm not just addressing to you, but it's all about for all of us. When we do anything, the mindfulness is always helping us by paying attention, the paying attention in the right moment, the right time with your present minds. It's all about alertness. It's all about awareness. What am I going to do? On purpose, which is nothing but why are you doing this activity? This is the one activity. Why are you doing any activities in your life? Whether it's studying, job, business, teaching, everything has a purpose. If there is no purpose, you can't do anything in your life, right? be in the present moment, focusing right here at point of life. Don't see out the world. Outer world is always distracting you. See yourself first internally. On this point, I have one good example. I'll use the word, addressing word. You have to identify the persons. Now I'm going to do that. My dear brothers and sisters.
Swami Vivekananda.
Very well. Bang on the point. When it was happened?
Chicago.
1883 Chicago, US.
Absolutely. 1883 in Chicago.
World Religion
World Religious Forum. The person who was put behind and who was called the later on after all the great speakers were on the stage on the dais. And Swami Vivekananda, when he was there on the stage, he was only paying attention to the right moment. He would have definitely got distracted if he have heard the bullying or maybe whatever happens to him. We don't know about that. But today we know Swami Vivekananda because he paying the attention on the right time. He was in the present moment. And he was on purpose not to look any external world. He was within himself. And that's where he used very simple words, my dear brother and sister. And today we still remember those simple one-line statement, my dear brother and sisters. And he was not judgmental about other people. Let me tell you guys. If he was a judgmental, he could have been not the greatest speaker at that point of time. And people have stand up and given a round of applause to that particular gentleman. So that is all about the mindfulness, right?
Right.
Are you with me on this point?
Absolutely, Vimal.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Now, this is what we all wanted to do it. Now, how we wanted to do it? What are the ways to do this? The mindfulness, as we have done, very simple exercise. Be yourself first. Okay. Let me ask you the one other questions because in the group, I can see lots of Gujaratis out here. And Gujarati always meant by money. Gujju always have money, right? Even though it's not money, he always attract the money with him, right?
Yes.
At least, jara zor se bolo yaar.
Barabar che, Vimal bhai.
Yes, Vimal.
Judgmental.
Ekdam barabar che.
Achiva.
Okay, so, sorry guys, I'm just taking. But let me ask you, where do we invest in life? Anybody, anyone who wants to give the answer, when we say the investment, where we go and invest, why do we invest? What is an investment for us?
For our life.
Learning.
Sorry?
Learning.
Yeah, learning, absolutely correct. Okay.
Investment on self.
Sorry?
Investment on yourself.
Okay, very well. Who said this? I am
not. Kamlesh.
Okay.
Investment is something that you do for long-term returns, right?
Very well, Ketki, very well.
Investment is for happiness.
Okay, investment is for happiness.
Vimalji, time is also an investment.
Time is also an investment. Very well said, Jayasri, very well said.
Investment for protection.
Investment for protections. Absolutely bang on the point, Kalpana ji, if I am not mistaken.
Yeah.
Investment for fulfilling your desires.
For desires. Jayas bhai, you bang on the point again. Very well said. To me, investment is not only the physical aspect of the life. Definitely, it's required to live in the life in this on this earth. But as a human, we are. Can you see my hands? Okay, let me come to this. Okay. We, yes, as a human, we always invest below the neck. That is the materialistic life. We always invest below the neck. That means, how do I look? How do I present to myself? What is the luxury which I have? Okay. What kind of property would I have? Very few people says about investment, time, happiness. Ganesh says, rightly says about happiness. Learning is one thing. How many of us are really investing above the neck? Can anybody answer to it? Above the neck.
Can you just elaborate on
Vimal, Rakesh here. All of us are investing above the neck. We have joined IITD.
You are absolutely bang on the point, and good round of applause for the Mr. Rakesh. I have the same point. Generally, we don't invest above the neck. The IITD is the platform where we have started to investing above the neck. Now, above the neck is not about only the face. Above the neck, there's your head, your mind. Okay. Likewise, to keep your body, keep running, you always have, you know, good food intake, the good nutrition, okay, proteins, vitamins, everything for your body. What about mind? How do you know be a mindfulness? To invest above the neck is all about having the good reading habits. Be with the nature. If you are there, always be with the nature. You always wanted to hear, you know, chirping of the birds. You always wanted to hear the nature voice. You know, the birds, the around surrounding. You wanted to see the beautiful nature with the actual colors. You don't want to go with, you know, the aesthetic colors or maybe you don't want to see the artificial colors, right? You always wanted to see the mountainary, green mountainary, waters, around everything put together, right? You always want to calm and compose positions where you go outside. All this brings to the inputs to your mind. If you see more to nature, if you see learn from the nature. You see sun every day, rising sun, sunset. You always see, you know, the life is always the next chapter. It gets rise and it gets set every day and night, right? So doing the mindfulness is all about to practicing yourself, be with the nature. Reads lots of inputs from the reading. I will not say read so and so, but always thoughtful reading is always helping. Fiction will not help you. It is always picking in anxiety. Do read with all about facts and file. Read about all the philosophical. I am just giving the examples. People will choose basis of their interest and the time they have. But that's all about your inputs to your mind, and that makes you mindful awareness. Are you with me on this point?
Yes, yes, Vimal.
Thank you. This is my most lovable slide out of the entire presentation. Can anybody read it? Deepika, would I request to please read this slide?
Yeah, please. Thinking is difficult, hence most of the people judge it. Better to deal with, get engaged to it.
Thank you so much, Deepika. So lovely voice you always have. So Henry Ford says, if you have the people around you, they generally judge you by your act, because for them thinking is difficult. And to deal with thinking, it is better to get engaged with it. Thinking is a process. It's not something which you do today and you get it out with that, no, next time. Thinking is always that back of your mind. If you keep thinking, you always get the better result. But if you keep thinking mindfulness, you always get a better result every time. You don't think today and get the result next time. But if you mindfulness, because you are in present mode, you do alertness, you have the compensant, and that uses lots of your calmness in your thinking process, right? As I already mentioned, what is mindfulness? It's nothing but it's in a lots of energy with the attention. While you do a mindfulness thinking, it's an attention. The position where you are, the place where you are, the situation where you are, it gives you attention and brings lots of energy to yourself to help you to think with mindfulness. Okay, you are about 100% what is happening all around you, but that always keep you alert with your position. It is essential basis for the healing and transforming ourselves and creating more harmony within the family, friends and work. It's a very simple statement, but if you relate with the statement, if you are alert in your positions, if you are aware about, you know, situations around you, if you are on a bad zone, if you are on a right zone, if you are going to be in a different zone, but if you are with your mind, you always easy with, you know, the situation. You don't have to worry about it, right? And while you're doing this all practices daily in and out, it is the miracle that you allow us to become fully alive in each moment. You don't be regret yourself that I could have been done so in past. And you can't have control over future as well. But you always have control what is your present with your alert mind. So that always brings, you know, with the alertness, the mindfulness, be with the passion and on the purpose. That is all about your alertness mind. I know that I am coming to the sort of my time or about to end my time. But my friends, I am coming to the session where I wanted to give away. What is you going to take away with you with by practicing the mindfulness thinking? Right? If you see the first para itself physically, we did an exercise. We did an exercise which is all with your body, with our physical aspect of the body, which enhance your neuromuscular strength and coordination. While you were, you know, breathing with your mindfulness thinking, you were able to check every senses of your mind, of your body, which you generally don't do that. Are you doing the regular basis? Answer is no. We don't do them regular basis. But today, well, for just 3 or 4 minutes, while we did that exercise for mindfulness thinking, we know every part of our body, how it reacting while we're taking breath in and out, right? It gives you the flexibility and balance to your thought process, which is always helping as a human, right? Because there are many of times that our thought process is beyond our control. But we do that with mindfulness. It is always the flexibility. You don't rigid with your thoughts, but you always have flexibility and balance. Better sleep is always a good recovery for your body and reduce fatigue. And it enhances your kinesthetic awareness. So where you are at the present moment, that awareness, your alertness is always, you know, top level. You'll be alert around the situation around you, and you always be, you know, ready to take the decisions or movement fast. How it helps to mental? Improve stress management. In today's world, the kind of workplaces, the family pressures, the social foundations, the social platform pressures, all pressures we live in, that gives us stress management. You can control your mind. You can control your all the desire with the control manners. Better concentrations and ability to perform in any situations. If your mind is stable, you are stable. Correct? Your mind stables, your thinking process are stable, and you go with the flow. You just can't get away with the flow. It keeps eliminating all your negative thoughts and decrease anxiety. You always been happy and lively mood. You don't think for no past, you don't too much thinking about the future, because more analysis paralysis, which I have learned. If you do more analysis, many people think that yeah, jada soch mat. That means jada analysis mat kar. Apne aap ko thoda relax ra. Be at time. More thinking is a more analysis. More analysis, many of times become the paralysis. So don't reach to the level where you get paralyzed, right? All the things will always help you to get emotional bonding. If you are positive, you always spread positiveness around you. If you are happy, people will come to you, will always find you happy. The other people also get happy. It's always give you less depressions, okay? You always in a lighter mood. It's always balancing between your calmness and the state of mind and strength and resilience. That is about our emotional health. And all these three things will help you to be in the greatest relationship warrior. In whatever relationship you are, family relationship, friends, your colleagues, your workplaces, your IITD family, and your extended family. If you are in mind, if you are in control mind, if you are in mindfulness, your relationship will always be on a next level. It's a good level. It's an improvement level. If you are not there, even though if you start practicing it, your relationship with your friends, colleagues, your family will always give you a good result. It reduces problems, because when you're happy, you don't tend to be, you know, get anger with the people. You don't get rage with the people. You accept the situation and you always come out with the better result. It gives you the social status. This person or that person was there and now is today is different than what we know that person. With your positiveness, your alertness, it always gives that impact in the social environment. So this is what the takeaway which I wanted all of my friends to take with your mindfulness thinking. Practice it out daily basis, and that gives me a kind of comfort and to give this 4 takeaway having this mindfulness thinking. Thank you so much. I was told by my colleague that not to use the word thank you, but sorry, because it's in the practice. But I don't have the thank you with the simple way. Without then the big B of the world, dhanyawad.
Fantastic. Good job.
Excellent, excellent, Vimal, excellent, excellent.
So mindful, Vimal.
Please, let's clap for him. I think it was a great, great presentation.
Superb, 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 superb. Just wanted it to go on and on, Vimal.
Very good, Vimal. Very good.
Suddenly left us with wanting for more. Fantastic.
Yeah, so
fantastic.
That's what my idea, to keep you engaged in right present moment and don't want to think for the future. If I were able to do that, I think I have done my presentation well. Thank you.
Excellent.
Thank you, Vimal. Thank you so much.
Yeah, I would like to your generous comment. Critical, constructive feedback, I'm always happy to, because this is my first ever presentation out of my comfort zone. I am more of technical side. So technically, if you ask me anything, I am like always be ready. But something which is psychological to think, and that this is my first ever presentation. And allow me one more minute. Before you give me a constructive or any feedback, I wanted to express my gratitude for the Dr. Rajan, the IITD family. Without those people, I am going to present, or I have presented, would not have been possible. Starting from the offline faculties, which obviously Payal, Sital, and Ami. Post that, there is the online faculties, Priya, Raghu Pillai, Smita Pradhan, Rupa, and all other faculties. Those who are like, who's changing our life, Dr. Nagarajan, and the entire platform, the facility which we all are using, by the way, thanks to Sakina, Purvisa and Sarmila. All these people was a great help to us. We are meeting, even though we are not been physically present at the retreat house, which is one of the beautiful place. I've been never to that. And all this connection, the mutual connections, the emotional connection which we have built up through this platform. I am thankful to everyone. And I should not forget to give my deepest gratitude to entire IITD family, to whom I have grown with my fellow colleagues, friends, and definitely the future competitor as well.
That's a good one.
Yeah. But that gives me lots of encouragement to be a best in myself. With that, thank you, everyone. Thank you so much.
Superb, fantastic, fantastic.
Yes, guys, anyone who would want to give him some feedback, please. Yes, Sanjay.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much for giving me a chance. Vimal, congratulations, first of all. As usual, wonderful, absolutely humble and simple. See, this is what immediately connects with everything. Your charming presence, your smile, your confidence, your coolness and body language, everything was absolutely, absolutely perfect. The way the slides you used, nice colors, nice pastel colors, you used more of blue and purple. I think maybe those are your lucky colors, or maybe favorite colors, blue and purple, that I could see. So that was all going superb. The activity, inferences which you gave, like attention, purpose, being in now and being non-judgmental, that came in such a beautiful cycle. It came like we were absolutely gripped and engrossed. Nowhere you missed the point or you went out of the track. You kept the objective until the end. The objective was like absolutely fully achieved. We never knew like you are going to say thank you so soon. You had 7-8 extra minutes with you. There could have been, I don't know, somehow I wanted more. You could have done wonders with those huge minutes you had. And at the end, with the gratitude which you showed for everybody in last 4 months, that was a wonderful act. And I literally enjoyed your presentations. All the best to you, Vimal. All the best.
Thank you so much, Jayesh bhai. Sorry, Sanjay bhai. Thank you so much, Sanjay bhai.
Yes, Kadambari ma'am. Yeah, you can unmute and share your feedback.
Yeah, Vimalji, it was a great presentation. I really enjoyed every minute of it. And you know, it really made you think, especially that exercise about, being aware of yourself, being aware of the present. I think that's what we all, because we live such a, you know, such an active, vast life that we think, we sort of forget to think about the present. We are always thinking about the future and what's going to happen and what's going to, you know, and we are always thinking about what we want to do next. So it is something which really is very, very well thought out. And it made me realize how, you know, to calm down and think about the present.
Yeah,
I really like that concept very much. Thank you for enlightening us.
Thanks. Thank you so much, madam. Thank you so much.
I'd like to give
feedback.
Can I?
Yes, yes, sure.
Who's
giving? Prashant, you're giving. Prashant, go on.
No, obviously, ladies. I will give afterwards.
Okay. Okay, thank you, Prashant. Vimalji, hello.
Thank you. Yeah.
It was a lovely presentation about mindfulness. I really liked it. I could connect more to you because my presentation was also on a similar topic.
Okay.
So it was nice, well framed. Your slides were fantastic. I liked the color scheme. They were very pastel, which did get a bit, quite a calm onto you, which was actually required since your topic was about getting calmness into you. So that is something that I really liked. I would just like to point out something with your permission, if it is okay with you.
Please, please don't hesitate, because that's where I'm going to learn more.
The activity that you did, in which you start from your forehead and then you go down. Okay? I really agree with what Payal said, because for me, what happened was that when you mentioned from your forehead, you go down to your nose. Okay. I, instead of it being a gradual flow, I had to jump from my forehead to my nose. From my nose, I had to jump to my throat. So instead of being a gradual flow, I was more into, oh, he said this. So beach ka bypass kar do aur abhi kudo. Okay. So it did not flow naturally to me. So my awareness more on being present in my flow, I was more present in the jumps from, you know, going from one point to the other.
Yes,
so please no hard feelings, just what
I if you allowed me to answer to it, it was a part of, you know, just to do a body scan with the mind. There is a long exercise to it, like around half an hour or so. I wanted to just take the part of it here to how we can do that exercise on a daily basis, because that is a long process. I do this practice nowadays, which is takes around half an hour. I wanted to just give a glimpse of that exercise that could be more impactful as the topic wise. So your point is well taken, madam. It's nothing that hard feeling is all about going to learn more in details wise. So thank you for your generous feedback. I am really appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, Mr. Vimal.
Thank you. Yeah.
Yeah. This is Prashant here from the weekday batch.
Yeah.
So we are seeing you for the first time, and it was an excellent presentation. And I have only 5 words for you.
Okay.
First is vibrant. V for vibrant. Second is I for intelligent, and M for mindful, and A for amazing, and L for loving. You are a very loving personality. Of course, you're very handsome also. So all in all, only Vimal.
You made it. Good
one, Prashant. That was really creative.
Prashant, very nice. Very creative and very nice.
Very good.
Prashant, that goes with your topic of creativity. Yeah?
No, very good. Yes.
Rakesh, here, one line.
Can I give one?
One. Vimal, you said you're doing it for the first time. Unless, had you not told us, I always thought you are a preacher.
Yes, sir. JD, sir, go on.
Vimal, Vimal, thank you very much for this presentation. It was really inspiring and, you know, engaging. Everybody has said about it, so I will just like to bring out one particular point, and that will probably help you and all of us to, you know,
please,
the kind of time you left out.
Yeah,
4-5 minutes. I don't know exactly how much. Maybe Priya Payal will say that. that is something which is your time, and you should never, never, never let that go. So you must make use of that. Maybe a little bit of practice could have helped you. As the feedback was there, the mind scanning exercise, maybe that could have been a little prolonged. That would have filled up that time, which was left at the 5 minutes. You being a Gujju bhai, I cannot allow you to, I cannot see you leaving, you know, wasting that opportunity. So that is the only suggestion from my side. Otherwise, excellent, engaging, and your dressing up, your background, excellent, very good.
Thank you, Jayesh bhai. If I may allow to give the answer to it, I didn't practice it. I don't have a time. Yesterday night, I completed the slide. Today morning, I have just go through it once. I haven't practiced it, but sorry. But your point taken, 100 out of 100, I will make next time, sure.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Great.
Yes, we'll take one more feedback.
Yes. Can I?
Yes, Dasrath ji, please.
Yes, Vimal. I mean, congratulations for your nice presentation and enlightenment one, right? I can see the background enlightenment you have. I can recollect the Maslow's last one of triangle, where it is said as self-actualization, right? I can feel that with little bit of practice, you can reach to that level and you can enlighten the life of the people in times to come. One of the things which you have mentioned, happiness, right? And it's not for you, it's for everybody else, because I'm attending so many webinars, and so I like to throw light on the happiness, what it is. It's for all the other trainers. People are using the term happy, happy. But according to me, happiness is a state of mind which cannot be kept constant. It keeps on changing from person to person and all the time. You cannot remain happy for 24 hours round the clock. But what we can do, we can be satisfied. Once we are satisfied, then only the happiness will follow. But that is a temporary phase. And the people can never be satisfied also, because a bird in hand is worth two in the bush, because people always try to aim that the bird in the bush rather than what is in the hand. So I mean, we are neither in present nor in future. So we person need to live in the present. Present means what? And gift, which we are giving it to ourselves and to others also. So person need to practice. I mean, all other things are irrelevant. If you are in present, you are the person to be watched out for. You are the person with a diamond quality, and nobody can stop you from achieving the success, whatever you aim in life. That is the things which I follow. Be in the present.
Thank you so much,
Vimal.
Thank you so much for such a lovely feedback. Thank you so much.
Yes, thank you.
I think Aynan sir wanted to mention something. Yes.
Yes, Vimal, I wanted to congratulate you for choosing a wonderful topic, that is thinking, thoughts. And I also wanted to confess with all of you that my company's tag is think through, take charge.
Oh.
The tagline of my company is, the trademark of my training is think through, take charge. Because, you know, thinking is the basic aspect of moving ahead. And as somebody said about the power of thinking, that your thoughts are the main ingredients of being powerful to achieve something. If you have no thoughts, nothing can be done. And I was attending Tony Robbins' Unleash the Power within just the last week, 4 days seminar, mind-boggling. He was just focusing on thoughts, thinking. So the topic what you chose is an extremely powerful topic. And you can build your entire training on this one word, thinking.
Thinking.
Okay. And I congratulate you for choosing this topic. Let's collaborate sometimes, because my process is also the same one. We can do wonders together. Yeah. Sure.
Thank you so much, Anand. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you all for your feedback. I would like to share mine, Vimal.
Please. Yeah.
Okay, so let me tell you, I really, really enjoyed the session. In fact, I wanted more, like someone said. And you had those 5 minutes more. I was wondering, why didn't you use it?
Yeah.
I would have really sat through if you had taken another half an hour of your session. I was really enjoying it. And the kind of inputs you were giving, your language was so simple, Vimal. It was something which you can connect with any kind of audience.
Yes. Right?
So that is something which we all need to keep in mind. Language has to be very simple. Words have to be very simple. You don't need to speak very hi-fi language to connect, right? So that is something I really liked. Clear messages were out. You know, I enjoyed the way the beginning when you started off and, you know, you asked, you know, Deepika came and introduced you. That was a very different way of doing a presentation. And I really liked that concept. Is really nice. You know, someone introducing the speaker of the day. Moving ahead, your topic, you know, you started with Think to Achieve, went on to mindfulness. You know, your background, your screen background, you're formally dressed, your confidence, everything goes very well. Your slides, the colors you've used, the flow, everything was very much in sync, right? And you spoke about the four types of thinking, the critical, the analytical, the mindfulness, and there was one more, creative.
Creative.
I think the way you explained it, you know, the examples you used. I remember one example, you said, help yourself first. And you gave the example of the, you know, you're sitting in a flight and the air hostess telling you, giving you instructions. And then you said, if something happens, you first help yourself and then only can you help others. Now, that example has stayed with me. It was so clearly, very simply put it, put forth, that it will always stay with the person that, yes, please help yourself first. Only then think about others, right? Also, the activity you did with us, the mindfulness activity where you gave us instructions, you took us through a short meditative process. The second one, and when you said, you know, can you feel pain? I actually felt pain on the back of my neck because I could actually, you know, get to that, get into that moment. And I know it is a very, very powerful technique. In fact, I would want to suggest that maybe the next time you take this session, wherever you take it, give a little more time. I know because of time constraint here, you couldn't give more time and it's absolutely understandable. But this activity could be so powerful for your session. So maybe if you can give a little more time, it will really, really be wonderful for your topic that you have taken. Mindfulness is my very, very favorite topic. And I think you did your best in explaining, giving us the right examples, taking us through the entire thing. Thank you very much. I really enjoyed it. And one big takeaway from your entire presentation is, for me, is one, be in the present moment.
Yeah.
Second, the thing you said about invest in yourself and invest above your neck, right? Yeah. It's always going to stay with me that yes, you know, we invest on so many different things, but what is the most important thing? Why are we missing that out, right? So that was very, very beautifully said. And I thoroughly enjoyed the session. Excellent.
Thank you so much, Payal. It's made my day and know the kind of efforts which I put in. I'm so Absolutely. Glad to hear
and
all.
And you said that you just finished your PowerPoint presentation last night and you did
yes, it is.
So well today. That's amazing. One little feedback I will give you, like JD sir already mentioned, that when you have time remaining in your session, never give that up.
Yes, I'll keep that.
If you take 2 minutes extra, it's still okay. But don't give up on your time. That is a very big opportunity. And, you know, you could have done so many things. You could have asked people, how did you feel the session was? Or you could have had a group discussion or anything. Always be ready with something. Then this is not just for you. This is for all of y'all. Especially when we go into corporates, you know, and when we are giving sessions, if we finish even 5 minutes before, they will say, yaar, vasooli nahi hui. Mindset. I'm not joking, you know. So
yes, it is.
They want you to give the entire amount of time to them. So if you have those 5-10 minutes, make best use of that time. Don't let it go. At the most, engage your participants and ask them to speak, ask them to come up with something. Think of something. Y'all are trainers, y'all are creative now. Y'all can start thinking like that. Okay, so don't ever give up on even 1 minute that you have. Never, never do that. Right?
Otherwise,
wonderful session. Thank you so much. I'm so glad I could be a part of it today.
I'm so happy. I'm so happy to, you know, receive all the feedback, which is definitely helping me. And last but not the least, I would really wanted to give my gratitude to my son, both the son who helped me a lot yesterday night, 10 o'clock, to complete the entire slide with the kind of transition it has. And I must say, thanks to my kids. Without them, the PPT would not have completed. And the kind of inputs which I have received from my friends, Deepika, I should not forget to mention her, because she was kind enough to call me and say, Vimal, need any help? Please let me know. So Deepika, Thank you so much for your all the helps. Thank you so much.
I can add on behalf of Vimal one thing. Don't consider it in a dead way that, you know, invest above your neck doesn't mean you go, all of us go start going to the beauty parlor and, you know, taking facial and all those things. Just a disclaimer. Thank you.
Yes.
Good one.
And that's why I asked Vimal to elaborate further at that time.
I think it was great.
Thank you, everyone. It really made my day, and no, I can establish myself as a, like, going to be a good trainer and presenter.
Absolutely. And this is such a hot topic and so much in the need right now. You can actually work on this model and make it a 2-day session, make it a full day session. There is so much that you can do in this topic.
I have lots of information, but to comprise in a 40 minutes, it's really difficult. But I have full information about how to can do it about. So we'll definitely.
I understand. And the topic is so vast. And whatever you took for us in those 35, 37 minutes, I think it was, you did a great job. Because also concising something and putting it in front of people is not easy. When you have so much material and you have to bring it down to this much, that is the most difficult thing.
Yeah. And it's just a doubt of benefit, or maybe in terms of, no, for every presenter out here. See, I'm from the technical backgrounds. I've been there in the printing industry so widely. So when we've been taught in our industry, we always thought the color speaks more about what it has. So as many people have now rightly mentioned about my PPT, so blue and those colors, it has their own language to express, while it did not require too much of the data to end. So blue, white, I'm just giving now the concept about the blue, white, and those colors is always helping you to present yourself very well. And hence, I'm always been choosy about those color in my background, blue, white, and green. That is a natural color and goes with the flow by itself. So with that, thank you, everyone. Thank you so much.